Hi, I'm Kim. I'm going to show you how to give your pet a subcutaneous injection of a medication that may have been prescribed by your vet. What you want to do before you start anything is make sure that you have your syringe ready and that it's the right medication and the right dose. So how you want to go about doing that is to potentially take off the covering, because some of our medications are light sensitive, so they are wrapped with vet wrap. So you want to take that off and make sure that the dosage in your syringe matches the label on the bag or the package that the injections are coming in. And once you do that, you're all set to get ready to poke your pet. The way that we typically do it and where we typically do it is right in the back, right around the shoulder area, right here where there's lots of loose skin and lots of space for you to do it. How I would go about pinching is I use my middle finger and thumb, and I grab their skin and pull up on their skin. This doesn't hurt them, and they usually don't notice that you're even doing it, as you can see. And then I'll take my pointer finger of my other hand and poke right between my two fingers to form a little pocket, and you'll be able to feel that really nicely. And that's where you're going to put the injection, is right in that pocket. Now, it doesn't matter which way you point the needle. It can be towards their head or away from their head, whatever you're more comfortable with. It's just important that you don't try and poke yourself. So you wanna make sure you go in at a 45 degree angle. So when you're ready, you can take the cap off. You can pull apart. It should come off very easily. And what I suggest doing is trying to just pull your hands right apart instead of trying to stop your hands from potentially poking into the skin with the needle, because your hands have a tendency to want to stop the jerk, and that's how people get poked. So once you take your cap off, you're all set. And then again, middle finger, thumb, pull up, use your pointer finger, make sure that the needle is pointing away from you to feel that pocket, and then try and keep your finger off the plunger when you're going to poke, so that you don't inadvertently spill or squirt all of the medication onto your pet's fur. Also, what you wanna make sure you're doing is you're keeping the bevel up on your needle. So if you look at it, you will see a little hole in the top where it tapers into a nice point, and that's the way you want the needle to go in, is with that hole pointing up, not down, because the fluid will flow in much easier and it will poke into the skin much easier. So when you want to go ahead and you're all set, you make sure you find that little pocket, you use a 45 degree angle, and you go ahead and give them a little poke, a nice little jab. It doesn't have to be hard and long, but you don't want to go too slow, because then that could hurt, and you may not find that subcutaneous space that we're looking to inject the medication into. And then you'll pull back on the plunger. Make sure there's no blood or air, because if you suck in a lot of air, then you may have poked through and through, and then you're gonna go ahead and inject. And then come out. I always give my pets a little rub where I've injected, just to make sure that I didn't squirt the medication onto their skin, because it will be wet. So you'll know that they didn't get the medication, and give them lots of praise. So if you have any questions about whether or not your pet received all the medication after you finished injecting them, please don't redose them and re-inject them. Contact your veterinarian and ask for further instruction.